Are you someone who thinks that 1200 calories is the magic number for you to lose weight? And if you eat any more than that, you are going to gain weight or you won't be able to reach your fitness and weight loss goals? Are you stuck on the fad diet train where you're trying this new fad diet or this new pill or this new supplement in order to lose weight? Or you think you need to starve yourself and not eat your favorite foods? I'm here to tell you this is not true and I want to help you. So watch this video right till the end and I'm going to tell you exactly what you need to do, how you can lose weight and still eat all your favorite foods and not be starving. We're gonna start by explaining what is BMR. But just quickly guys, if you're new here, make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit that bell to be notified. I'm releasing new videos every week and you don't wanna miss out when a new video drops. BMR is basal metabolic rate. This is the amount of calories that your body needs to survive, for your lungs to work, for your digestion to work, to help build lean muscle, to lay in bed, to do literally just function in life. We're going to learn how to calculate that number. The reason we need to know this number is to know how many calories you need to eat in order to lose weight or to just function in life comfortably. Next, we're going to talk about daily energy expenditure. So your TDEE, that's total daily energy expenditure. So how many calories your body burns just doing your moderate daily activities, including your workouts and basically everything you do throughout the day. So once we have our BMR, our basal metabolic rate, our TDEE, our total daily energy expenditure, we will have a much better idea of how many calories you need to be eating to lose weight, to feel amazing, to build lean muscle and blast body fat. Okay, I'm gonna start by showing you the simplest and easiest way to calculate your personal BMR. Okay, basal metabolic rate. The reason you want to know your personal basal metabolic rate is because you are different than your friend, than your mom, than your husband, than your dog. Your body is your body, so in order to fuel your body properly, we wanna know what your body is doing. We don't wanna eat however many calories your friend is eating to lose weight. It might not work for you. Okay, the best way to find your basal metabolic rate is by using the Harris-Benedict formula. It looks a little bit like this. Yes, that's a lot of numbers and it's confusing. It's very simple to go through the calculation, but I'm gonna be completely honest, and if you Google BMR calculator, that's also a very simple way to find your BMR, ensuring that it's a calculator using the Harris-Benedict formula. I'll leave a link in the description for the calculator that I use all the time with my clients and myself that works really well to find your BMR. Some of you might actually be surprised to see how many calories your body needs just to function. If you laid in bed all day just for your organs to work, this BMR number, that is how many calories your body needs. And most likely it's more than 1200, I'll tell you that. Okay, now that we've calculated our BMR, our basal metabolic rate, we're gonna go on and calculate our TDEE, so our total daily energy expenditure. How many calories our body actually burns combining our BMR as well as our activity levels. So here is the calculator for calculating your TDEE. So basically all you need to do is multiply your BMR number that we just calculated with the number beside the activity level that relates to you. If you have a physical job, remember to add that into account. If you have a desk job, that's something you also want to take into account. So maybe you have a desk job, but you still work out 3 to 5 times a week, still put yourself in that moderate category. Again, with a quick search on the internet, there are so many calculators to calculate your total daily energy expenditure if you don't want to test your math skills today. I'll put a link in the description for the calculator that I recommend that I use often with clients and with myself to get these numbers quickly and effectively. Okay, now that we have our basal metabolic rate and our total daily energy expenditure, we know how many calories our body needs just to function. So remember, this is just the number we need to function in life. If you're working out really hard, if you have more muscle mass, if you're looking to build more muscle mass, this is where we play around with these numbers, and this is where we actually come down to your calorie maintenance numbers, your calorie deficit or calorie surplus if you're looking to put on some muscle. Make sure you check back next week. I'll be releasing a video showing you exactly how to calculate your calorie deficit for weight loss. So if you're looking for effective long-term weight loss without dieting or starving yourselves, make sure you subscribe and check back next week. Hit that bell to be notified, and you will get a notification when I release that video showing you exactly how to do that. I'll leave a link in the description to the video I created, a quick MyFitnessPal tutorial to show you the simplest way to track what you're eating every day, your macros, and your calorie intake. It's always good to know this, especially if you're someone who eats out a lot, or if you eat the same things every day, you wanna know how many calories you're taking in. You don't have to track forever, but it's always good to know these numbers, and that's how we can play around with those numbers. If you're not reaching your weight loss goals, we might be able to figure it out why. Also, when you start tracking in MyFitnessPal, it's gonna start talking about macros. That's your macronutrients, your proteins, your carbs, and your fats. If you're interested to know what kind of percentages of each of these foods you should be eating for your body type to reach your goals, I created a 7-page free guide breaking it all down for you and explaining it in the simplest form. I'll leave the link in the description for that free guide. I hope this helped you a lot. I hope it made you realize that you are allowed to eat more than 1,200 calories in a day to reach your weight loss goals. And I hope you learned something. Thanks again for watching, guys, and I hope to see you in the next one.